Hi folks. Well, as you know, lighting these videos in this room is no easy task. Well, not without going completely overboard with the lighting. So I'm going to try putting the camera in a few different positions and we'll see how things go. I'm not a fan of this particular position because it looks like I'm getting hot spots. And not only that, you can see more of the mess behind me. Oops. Anyway, in this video, I'm going to cover a couple of things I forgot about the Good Food Show, and also we're going to take a look at this. The garlic beer. There was something else in the VIP goodie bag that I forgot about, and that was a small Fever Tree tonic water. As you can see, we're getting quite hot on the label there. Comes in a variety of different flavours, available in a number of UK supermarkets, but not all the supermarkets seem to carry all the flavours. Fever Tree's slogan is something along the lines, if three quarters of your drink is the tonic, you might as well make it a good one. And this is one of the better ones. The other thing was, again, it was VIP related, and when you were in the main hall having your food, there was a section of tables set aside for the VIPs, so if you'd paid a bit extra, you were able to go to a dedicated bank of tables when everyone else was fighting over a place to sit. That was about it. Right, let's get the bottle opener and have a crack at this garlic beer. It says it is 500 ml, 4.1 ABV, 2.1 units. Ingredients: fine malted barley, wheat, Goldings and first grade hops, black garlic, yeast, water. Contains cereals containing glutens. Okay. Basic tasting notes, blah blah, basically tasted chilled, etc. etc. So let's crack this open. Okay, I'll find that later, or probably my foot will find it later when I get up from the chair. Let's have a crack at this. Now, they said that when chilled it tastes a little bit like licorice with other flavours. There's a good degree of bubbling in there. Don't know if you can see that. Right. The nose is rather like a shandy. Rather like a lager shandy. Beer shandy, sorry. Sort of like Bass shandy. If you know that one. Yeah, like a Bass shandy, beer shandy. Nothing overly special, really. Oh dear, bit of a letdown. Yeah. Not getting too much of an aftertaste, really. Relatively inoffensive, and probably more for the novelty value than anything. I'm not really getting too much of a flavour of much in the line of garlic in there. Yeah, pardon me, must be the bubbles. Tastes like any other relatively inoffensive beer shandy, to be perfectly honest. Yeah, no other real serious notes in there to report. Oh well, that's about it, I suppose. Oh well. See you later.